good, everyone? It's Steve from Sneaker Tech Talk, back with another video today. For today's video, we will be taking a look at the Air Jordan 8 in the playoff colorway. So really quickly, as far as the box goes for this release, you do have an OG inspired gray and black top Air Jordan box. I do believe the OGs had a Nike Air in the corner. As far as the size tag label, it does read Air Jordan 8 Retro, black, true red, white, and I did get these in a size 10.5. So without further ado, let's take a look at the Air Jordan 8 in the playoff colorway. All right, so just before getting started, I just wanted to mention that this release in general just really surprised me. I can remember my first release of Air Jordan 8s back around 2002 or 2003. And all the way from back then up until now, 8s have never really been popular. But online here in Canada, these things flew. Like, they completely sold out. There was like some small sizes or really big sizes left online on all the websites. My local Foot Locker here in Calgary, Alberta, they did have a few bigger sizes left, so I was able to snag my size 10.5. But online here in Canada especially, like, these things were gone. And especially at the price point of $270 Canadian, $210 over in the US, I feel like the price point for these is really high. Even back in 2015 when the Aqua 8s came out on, I believe it was Black Friday, those even sat for a couple weeks here in Canada. So for me, I was very surprised to see these sell through pretty quickly. But without further ado, let's get into the shoe. So what you're getting here is an Air Jordan 8 in the playoff colorway. These did originally release back in 1993. We did see a retro in 2007 and 2013. And then here in 2023, we are seeing another reissue, and for the first time with the red pull tab here at the back. So we have not seen it with the OG featured red pull tab until 2023. Every other release had a black pull tab. So starting at the bottom of the shoe, you do have this kind of circular traction pattern here. It's kind of got little cutouts and little circles with a yellow Jumpman at the forefoot. So a pretty crazy design. As far as traction goes for these indoors and outdoors, these should have you covered. You know, they're a 90s traction pattern, so they will not wear away quickly at all. As far as the midsole goes, you do kind of have a black midsole, whereas I know a few of the other releases had more of a gray midsole, and they do have that sparkle within the midsole as well. So you are kind of getting those OG features. And really quickly, I just wanted to mention that if you jump over to MJO 23 Dan or OG or Bust here on YouTube, they do have full comparisons from the 1993 pair and this 2023 pair. So if you want to take a look to see how they compare from the OGs until now, jump over to their pages. I will link their videos in my description. But moving your way up from that midsole, you do have this multicolored kind of white patch here with white, black, and red. You get that on the lateral and medial side. And then you do kind of have a two-tone upper. So the strapped portion is kind of a jet black, and then the material on the toe box, and then the perforated material here throughout the upper on the lateral and medial side is kind of a different material altogether. It's almost like a leather. Not quite a leather, but it feels like leather, and it kind of has that, I don't know, over texturized material. So, and then you do have these two cross straps here, which are Velcro. Kobe Bryant notoriously wore these in 03, unstrapped. And I will show you what that looks like here on the left shoe. And it does have the 2-3 here on the overlay strap. And then underneath those straps, you do have the lacing system here. And then you do kind of have that wristband material here, like the red Jumpman. And then this tongue is like a neoprene material. It's kind of like a neoprene booty here, actually, in the Air Jordan 8, similar to the Huaraches. Obviously, these were designed by Tinker Hatfield. So you do kind of have that neoprene booty here with the multicolored print on the inside, on the heel, and behind the tongue. And then on those straps that actually strap down, it does say Air Jordan, as you can see here on the lateral. And on the medial side, there are some perforations throughout the upper for breathability, but overall, I think this is gonna be a pretty hot shoe to wear. As far as the tech within the midsole, you do have two encapsulated air sole units, one in the heel and one in the forefoot. And overall, I think this is a great looking shoe. MJ absolutely killed it in the 1993 NBA playoffs, going on to win his third NBA championship while wearing these in the playoffs. More or less the same on the right shoe. The material's pretty nice, but the OGs were jet black throughout the whole upper with the white edge lines here on the material, whereas you're not getting that. My good friend Ryan 4Z23 did color his edges with a crayon. I'll throw up some photos of his. I don't think I'll be doing it, but it is a pretty cool look, kind of drawing inspiration from the 1993 pair. And then the back, you do have this ribbing here at the back, some more of that kind of nubuck or suede material. And overall, this is a very clean colorway. Let me know if you guys picked these up. Again, they were $210, $270 here in Canada. And then in Soul Collector issue 22, the celebration of the Air Jordan 23, you have all of the models here in this magazine. And as you can see, back in 1993, you had the white, black, and reds, the aquas, and then the playoffs. And then in 03, we got the chromes and the white, black, and reds again. And then a slew of low tops, and we actually did see the low tops in 2003. So they did drop in low top form, and then in 07, we saw them again. This magazine only goes up to 2008. So we don't have the 2013s in here, but you do have a slew of player exclusives. And then the next page does show the Key Tech encapsulated aerosol unit, 4 foot and heel, full length dynamic fit inner booty, integrated and anti-inversion strap system. Great use for indoor and outdoor. Original retail price was $135 for all the retros. The OGs, sorry, back in 1993 did retail for $125. And they did get a rating score in 1993 and back in 08, a B minus. And then obviously also in 1993, Enter the Wu-Tang, 36 Chambers Wu-Tang Clan hits the streets. So this magazine definitely has some cool features as far as all the original releases and when they came out. But let me know what you guys think of the Air Jordan 8 in the playoff colorway. For me, it's an absolute classic. I was a little hesitant to pick them up originally because of the price point, but them having them in store, I did message a friend over at my local Foot Locker and they had a size 10.5, so I did go and grab them. Now, as far as the fit goes, back in 07 with the Aqua release, I believe it was 07, I did go with a size 11, and they were pretty snug in a size 11. But here in 2023, I went with a size 10.5, and my toe is right near the end of the shoe, kind of where they were with that size 11 in 07. So definitely, if you guys can try them on, they are pretty roomy in my opinion, but I really like the overall fit and look of the Air Jordan 8s. I think it's a classic shoe, a great design by Tinker Hatfield, and it is the 30th anniversary for this shoe, so I was definitely happy to see them come back with that OG red pull tab. But overall, let me know what you guys think of these shoes in the comments. I think it's a great retro release. Happy to see them back. Let me know if you guys picked them up. But as always, if you guys could like, comment, and subscribe, that does help the channel a ton. And check out my Instagram over at Sneaker Tech Talk. It is an extension of my YouTube channel with all my pickups, basketball footage, and nostalgia as a whole. But like I said, that's going to do it for today's video on the Air Jordan 8 in the black, true red, and white playoff colorway. As always, thanks for watching today's video, and until next time, peace. I never switch sides, like even when I die, I'm a ride for the squad, lot of ties in the hearse. I've been